Thanks so much for being here. My name is Kat and I make houseplant videos here on Good and Planty. If you just so happen to absolutely love this video, please consider liking it, commenting, subscribing, or following me on Instagram. All of these things help me grow my channel like a plant. When you're a plant parent, it is like being a regular parent, hard to be perfect. So today, I kind of just want to air out my dirty laundry and basically just share with you all my bad plant habits. And guess what? These are habits that I kind of get away with. I basically just want to share this to A, inform people on what is like technically good and bad, and B, to alleviate plant parent guilt. So once again, disclaimer, these are bad plant habits. These are not tips. These are not things that I have recommended or do recommend. I'm just sharing kind of like a realistic look at my plant care, what I get away with, and whatever. I gave the spiel, but I need to just clarify that so nobody yells at me. I'm so nervous about this microphone situation. Can you tell? Bad habit number one, I water my plants, all of my plants, with tap water. Yes. I rarely take the time to go through and water my picky plants with distilled water. That's just the reality of the situation. I find it to be a huge headache to go through and water my plants, take mental notes on who I need to come back to with a separate watering can, and then also take care of those. So everybody just gets tap water now, and it is what it is. In fact, I have been doing, specifically here in this place because the sinks are a little bit better for it, I've been doing a lot of in-sink watering. I just take a boatload of plants over to the sink, I water them that way, and then I bring them back. It saves me a lot of mess, believe it or not. It's very efficient, and it gives the plants a very thorough water. It's not ideal for them, but I honestly just prefer it at this point. Some plants can handle it a little bit better than others in my collection. For example, my spider plants absolutely hate it. Their tips are so crispy. And similar to my peacefully, I have never watered the peacefully with distilled water, even though that is what I recommend doing. It's just such a big plant that if I had to water it with distilled water, I would go through so many gallons of distilled water that it's just unrealistic. But that plant also shows signs of some unhappiness with that decision. Some plants that have taken that switch a little bit better, that surprised me, honestly, is my Alocasia poly. That plant has been taking my tap water pretty well. And also this little Calathea musaica that was reclassified, but I cannot remember the correct genus. Those are some plants that I was actually surprised took the tap water fairly well. Horrible habit that Kat has, number two. I have been placing my plants around the house based on my aesthetic desires over their planty needs. To be completely honest, once I moved, I had a really hard time placing all of the plants in a way that looked good to me and also suited all of their needs. I just decided to design with them and do what looks good to me over kind of nitpicking every little plant position in my collection because I have 100 plants. It would be impossible to find the perfect spot for every single plant. So yes, a lot of my plants are placed in ideal spots, especially the more expensive ones, but I have plenty of plants that I just stuck there because they look good. If you watched my houseplant tour, which by the way, you should absolutely watch my houseplant tour. I mentioned that I did that with the rubber tree I have downstairs. It is a plant that likes very bright light, and instead it's kind of tucked in a corner behind the TV. Over there, I also have a Begonia Rex that I think likes a bit of bright and direct light that is also a little bit in lower light. And you know what? They're doing okay. It's been a little bit over a month now, and they're handling the lower light just fine. Of course, it is summer, so it is very light naturally in the space, but I don't know. My take is that I'm just gonna be monitoring them and seeing what happens, and if they start to get a little bit cranky, I'll move them, because at the end of the day, a sick and unhappy plant is not gonna look good anywhere. Bad plant habit number three. This one might get a little bit controversial, but I'm gonna be brave. I have been calling it quits on plants a lot more often. I know, like literally, I know. I have always advocated for, I hope this microphone is okay. I'm so nervous about this. I've done plenty of test runs, but this is my first time filming, so I hope it's not a waste. But anyway, I have always advocated for rehabbing a plant that is not doing well over throwing it away, or giving a plant you're no longer absolutely in love with away to a friend. That is definitely, and it still is my first option. That is absolutely what I recommend doing. But I think that after the move, I kind of got a little bit more realistic with it. I definitely tossed a few plants during this move. I was really stressed out. I had a lot of plants, some that I honestly just wanted to prioritize because they meant more to me or cost me more money. My mental health was struggling during the move with all of the stress, so some plants did get kicked to the curb, and I think I just want to remind everyone that it's okay to do that. Like, it's not the end of the world. You are not a horrible person. You can still absolutely love nature and respect nature and hold houseplants close to your heart even if you throw out a plant. You can absolutely try again. There's no need to beat yourself up over it. Just make sure that you're not, like, you know, buying and disposing of houseplants regularly. But I think you know what I mean when I say that it is okay to call it quits with a plant. Whether you want to give away a plant, rehab a plant, or once in a while just toss it because it's not doing too good, it's okay. Maybe you're giving someone like a dumpster dream story or something. So to wrap up this one, I just wanna have a moment of silence for some of the plants that did not make it through this move. They were having a hard time, and the horrible, horrible cat just ended it. All right, tip number 4 is out of sheer laziness, and I can absolutely admit my faults there, and that is not cleaning my leaves enough. I have been so bad at keeping up with leaf cleaning because with 100 plants, it's so hard. My house gets dusty within a week, and that has been true no matter where I live. So to think of cleaning 100 plants every single week, it's unrealistic. A lot of my bigger plants I did give an actual clean with my DIY leaf cleaner. If you haven't seen that video, I will link it up above if you want to know how I do it. I did clean some of the bigger plants with that mixture just because they were absolutely like filthy. There was like a layer of dirt on those plants. But a lot of my smaller plants, I have just been taking to the sink, as I said, and as I'm watering them in there, just running the water over the leaves to get rid of that little layer of dust. It's absolutely better than nothing, but I do want to be transparent that it does leave a layer of hard mineral stains from the tap water on the leaves. I've noticed this a lot on my Philodendron Prince of Orange. That plant definitely is not loving the tap water on its foliage, but it is better than nothing. I will get around to doing a heavy clean on some of these leaves, but you're not a bad person if you don't clean your leaves constantly. Promoting pests, maybe. Blocking some ideal sunlight, maybe. Bad person, no. Okay, and the last tip, oh my God, no, these are not tips. The last confession that I have for all of you is that I am a heavy pruner. I have a heavy hand with the scissors, and not for propagating. This is a bit of a mixed confession because I don't think it's always a bad thing, and I'll share more on why. I wouldn't outright recommend this, especially if not across all plants. So basically what I mean by this confession is that if a leaf is looking kind of like it's gonna go maybe in a week or two, like it's just starting to show signs of yellowing, I will cut that sucker off without even thinking twice about it. I totally fall into the trap of wanting my plants to look ideal and have minimal yellow leaves just for me, not even so much for Instagram or anything. It's just I like to look at them when they look nice, and that is my perfectionism showing. Sometimes this can be a little bit of a bad thing. For example, this Aglaonema behind me looks fairly leggy, and I've actually had to prop it up with a chopstick and some wire because the bottom leaves, it's hard because I think that those leaves would have gone regardless, but I do have a heavy hand, so I might have cut off some leaves maybe a little bit too soon. Who's to say? And then also, my Philodendron Florida Ghost is another example of a plant that, you know, maybe it wasn't super beneficial for me to have such a heavy hand. It has such few leaves left compared to where it was before, and I did also cut off the new growth point because it got a little bit damaged in the move. So now I kind of left this already struggling plant with only a few leaves to generate new growth. However, I will say some plants have actually benefited from this habit of mine. Again, the Calathea musaica, that got a very, very, very heavy chop from me because it was not doing well, and instead it promoted new growth to come out from the bottom. And I also notice a similar pattern with Peperomia, Hoya, and Pothos. So those are plants that I have definitely been, you know, a little generous with the scissors, but have all bounced back and honestly look a bit fuller because of it. So in conclusion, yes, I will continue to say that you should water some plants with distilled water because you should. And I will continue to say that you should clean your leaves because you should. But I also can very much admit and see how it can be overwhelming to keep hearing these tips, knowing full well that I don't always follow them religiously. I will get like DMs and comments from super stressed plant parents over some of these things that I've talked about today, and I just wanted to let you all know that I do it too. I'm not perfect, it's okay. If you're feeling a little risky and bold, comment down below some bad habits, quotes, bad habits that you have. We can all kind of confess. Oh my God, the microphone, I'm so scared. We can all kind of confess down below together. Thank you all so much for watching. I hope this was a little bit more interesting. I kind of wanted to break up the tips and the vlogs a little bit and be a little real with you. Please subscribe to my channel if you're not already and you want to see more planty content from me. Down below in my description box are a bunch of links and ways you can support me and my channel, some free, some not. Oh, and also if you really like this sweatshirt that I'm wearing, it's also linked down below. So yeah, I will see you in my next video. Bye.